Welcome to the video pitch for the paper Distant Space Multi-Robot Coordination on Pocket Drones. During this video, I will give you a short introduction over the idea, implementation and results presented in the paper. Providing multi-robot coordination on ultralight robot platforms like for example Pocket Drones is challenging, since they are not able to carry sophisticated and heavy sensors and have limited computing power. These limitations make it harder to localize cooperating robots, which therefore complicates basic coordination tasks like collision avoidance or formation control. The system presented in this paper uses ultra-wideband distance calculation in combination with additional velocity measurements to determine the relative position of other drones or target positions. The position estimation is done by a recursive neural network in combination with a particle filter. Our experiments show that the combination of both techniques allows a faster conversion time and a more stable prediction compared to a pure recursive neural network or pure particle filter configuration. The policy for navigation collision avoidance is provided by a deep Q learning network which is trained in simulation. As shown in the following two clips, the proposed system is able to autonomously navigate the drones to their target position while avoiding other drones on the way. It is mostly relying on distance data provided by the ultra-wideband communication to accomplish this task. The advantage of using ultra-wideband communication for robot sensing is that the hardware is relatively light, which allows us to use drones with a low payload. In order to make a valid movement decision, the network requires a position estimation of the closest drone and the target position. This is accomplished by the recurrent neural network in combination with the particle filter. The recurrent network estimates target and drone positions based on a sequence of states, and the filter uses these predictions to spawn new particles if the probability of the current estimation is under a certain threshold. By incorporating the network's prediction into the particle filter, we are able to reduce the number of required particles to a minimum, while still accounting for the sensor noise. This reduces the computational overhead, which allows the real-life application on pocket drones. For more detail about the system, experiments and results, have a look at the paper or visit us at the interactive presentation.